Hi, welcome everyone. Thanks for joining us into our little talk for today. Today we're joined by Joanna Kinsman of Keeney Bands. Thank you, Joanna, for taking some time this morning to talk with us.
Of course. Thank you.
Yeah, so tell us a little bit about yourself. I mean, like your background for starting Keeney Bands and like what your passions are for it.
Definitely. So let's see. I started Keeney Bands. It's been 8 years, I realized, the other day. And so it's a long time. you and I probably connected back when I was designing swimwear, right?
I think so.
Yeah. And so
it's been a while. Yeah.
Yeah. That was a few years before that. And, you know, really, I was trying to get the swimwear off the ground. And, you know, just it was tough because I was trying to self-fund it and I had all the seasonality of it. And, you know, I didn't know what I was doing at the time. I'll be honest. And, you know, trying to, it was a very daunting, experience trying to handle my, you know, the production, my sales, and just all of that. But I had this mentality that I could just do it all on my own. So long story short, I couldn't. And, but in the meantime, it was great because I had all this extra material from the, from my swimwear line. And, you know, I started to take on, kind of go back to my roots of marketing and everything that I had done before all of that. And I'm just taking on these little part-time jobs, still learning a lot. And then I came up with Keeney Bands, which were basically made out of a swimmer material. So it all worked out, you know, full circle. And so, yeah, I started that. I put it up online. I just was like, hey, you know, who likes these? And I got a couple hits of, a few friends that had retail locations. And so they said they'd be willing to try them out. And so I started right down that path of getting into wholesale. And, yeah, I haven't looked back since.
Nice. So I have a question for you, Joanna. I'm looking through your Insta right now, Keeney Bands, and I have friends that I'm like, oh, these are really cute. Like I know, you know, some of my friends would like to shop there and I'll be referring them over to you. But I'm curious is when you came up with Keeney Bands, was it, you mentioned that it was leftovers from your bikinis, but do you design with the girl in mind or do you then try to market and sell your product after the fact? So do you kind of sit there and think like, I want to come up with a product for someone who's active in Southern California, maybe she serves, you know, she goes from brunch to the beach, or is it the other way around?
I would say it's the other way around. Really the hair ties were kind of a fluke that, you know, I just kind of on it. I was like, all right, cool. We've got this stuff. But then it's all just sort of been a little bit more reactive, I would say. Well, I shouldn't say that. It's a little bit of both. Some of our locations, you know, they would just say, hey, do you have headbands? Do you have scrunchies? Do you have, you know, do you have hair clips and this and that? So we've added because of that. So, but also trying to be proactive and looking at what's next, what are the next trends and hair accessories and everything. So, it's been, you know, fun, interesting and, you know, the ups and downs and all of that too.
Nice.
Cool. Well, you mentioned that you were started out as trying to design swimwear.
Yeah.
Who would you say you would see as like your major fashion influences?
Well, you know, I've got to say, I'm not really designing a whole lot these days. Okay. It doesn't matter. I do, you know, I still absolutely love fashion. I always had just so much respect for, obviously I love Chanel. But I'm a huge just Marc Jacobs fan because I love the commercial.
Oh, okay.
Just somebody that I can see, they've, you know, created this just very timeless products, but that also can reach masses too. So, you know, but, you know, something like Chanel, obviously, I mean, who doesn't love her?
Where do you see yourself going in the future? I mean, you started out with a few retail shops. I think I read online that you're now up to 500 into 500 stores. Where do you see yourself moving beyond that?
So we're in, I would say about 1,000 locations.
Oh, 1,000 now. Nice.
Yeah. With COVID, I'm not really sure, you know, we still need to kind of do an audit on who's still, you know, kicking with us and who isn't. So yeah, we'll have to get those numbers to shake out. But fortunately, I've been working with fitness franchises. So Club Pilates, Pure Bar, Cycle Bar are our biggest ones. Oh, and nice. Yeah, we're working on getting into more of those. So it's really, again, with COVID has changed the nature of my business where it's not just hair accessories anymore. We do a lot of branding for these guys. So hats, bags, jacket,
oh, cool.
active okay. wear now, jewelry, you name it. So yeah, the name of the game on our wholesale side has really changed a lot.
You mentioned the pandemic, and I noticed that you're also kind of expanded into mask. How is that line working for you? Have you seen a lot of people, accessorizing with the new accessory, I guess, of the last year and a half, which is, the designer mask?
Yeah, I've got to say, nobody likes wearing face masks, but we had fun with it. And I had all this extra material for, first and foremost, that was just sitting there. So we were able to make masks out of that, which is a great breathable material. On top of that, we had the strings already too, because we were working on a line of hair ties that for more fine hair. So, which I hadn't, I hadn't rolled out yet, but all of a sudden, I've got all the rolls of the right string. I've got the right material. So it's sort of like, right place, right time to make that pivot into there. And ours were definitely the most comfortable, combined with the cutest. And, and then we added mask bags for people to put their masks in and mask chains as well. And then we started offering them. Initially, it was just in women's. We added men's, we added children's, we added a custom option too for our larger accounts. So, we pushed out a lot of masks during COVID. So, we keep up. So that was a high quality problem at least to have.
Yeah.
It sounds like you're really rolling with the punches, like with a lot of other small businesses that are seeing, how they have to change their business to meet the demands as they change, sometimes month to month.
Yeah. Yeah. Without a doubt. It's all about pivoting. And I think that COVID really showed, if you were resilient, that really stood out. And that was super important. People got very creative some people couldn't handle it, or, at least maybe for a short period of time. So I think it put us all really to the test. And, despite everything, all of the negative, part of COVID, it really was sort of like an opportunity, for business owners to kind of like step up, pivot, maybe it's just show goodwill to other people. And that's not just business owners. That's, just people in general. So, it's definitely an interesting time.
Absolutely. The other thing that I was really interested in talking to you about, Joanna, is your social media. I'm a really big Instagram follower. I love, following different brands, different influencers. I noticed that you have a really good brand identity on Instagram. Can you talk about that? Like, how did you develop your social media presence online?
Oh, thank you. I started doing it all myself, as we, bootstrapping entrepreneurs do. I fortunately have a girl that I had initially hired to help me more with, cutting, tagging, just kind of anything that needed to be done, filling orders. And then she transitioned into just handling that. So, and she just kind of gets it. She's got a great eye. And, I think I don't want to say I used to be more creative, but I used to be almost like allowed to be more creative, and I was designing and everything. And now my role is really focused now more on business development. And I say I'm the ideas and decisions. I like to be able to give people, make people more empowered on my team to be creative. And I love just seeing other people's ideas and kind of giving them the space to be the creative ones too.
That's cool. So as a small business, I know a lot of small businesses, they tend to outsource a lot of their, the construction portion of it. But you say you do all of your cutting and sewing in-house still. Is that correct?
We actually have a cutting contractor. But just when we've got new stuff, smaller pieces, we just, we cut it in-house. Say we'll get one piece of fabric, and then we'll take that and we'll make it up, say, in every style that we have. and then
Put
up online, and then just sort of see how it goes. From there, we can get it cut.
Nice.
Yeah, but sewing is all. Also, we've got contractors for that too. So yeah, we definitely do a lot of outsourcing, and then also admin outsourcing too. I've got a graphics guy who's overseas in India, and an awesome admin girl who's in India as well.
Very cool. So I have a really big question for you. So it's not very specific to, you know, design, but looking again at your Instagram, I saw that you're a big proponent of like doing what you love and like following your dreams. For people that are artists that have the creative side down, but not necessarily the business aspect of it. And I said, this is a big question. So if you need a moment, definitely take a moment to think. But what kind of advice would you give to those people that, you know how to create art, are very passionate about their art, you know, whether it be design or, you know, painting or photography, but don't necessarily have the business side going on? What would your advice be for them to get started on the business aspect of it?
Definitely. I really love that question because, yeah, a lot of artists aren't business savvy. You know, they may not necessarily be organized, but they have beautiful products, and that those products deserve to be displayed and like shared with the world, right? So it is that it's tough. And you see that, you know, I see beautiful art or, you know, designers, and I'm like, oh, like more people should know about this, right? I went to business school, but I was always a creative as well. So I've always kind of felt very grateful for having both of those sides to me. But I don't think that someone necessarily needs to be good at both, or like, you know, but they need to, yeah, definitely need to understand it. For those, you know, for the artists that really are just, you know, 100% creative brain, I think it is sort of understanding the basics and, you know, taking imperfect action, but definitely, you know, taking some sort of action. Like, I think one of the biggest things I hear, you know, say, you'll take a jewelry designer, for example, you know, and, you know, start talking about their business. I'm like, oh, my friend's working on my website. And I'm like, oh no, that's not a good thing. You know what I'm talking about too, right? Or the other one is, I just need business cards. And then they think that they're set and they're ready to go. it is tough. Yeah. You know, taking that imperfect action is not, you know, don't wait for, you don't even need to wait until you have a website. Send people to your Instagram. You don't need to have business cards. Mm-hmm. Send people to your Instagram. Just get yourself out there, and see who bites, see who likes it. And, you know, you can kind of take it from there. I just remember like the first time I sat at a meeting with somebody who goes, she goes, can you send me your line sheets? And I'm like, yeah. And I go home. I'm like, what are line sheets? And I made it up. But
fake it till you make it, right?
Yeah, yeah.
I really like that quote of yours, take imperfect action.
Yes, thank you. It's super important because there are so many people. I've had clients, because I do some consulting too, that take so much time and money to make everything just perfect. And then actually launching, some people just enjoy that part more. And, you know, and then they never got their actual product out. So you don't want to see that. So I've always had to bootstrap. So I always call myself kind of a bulldozer when it came to like work and business and everything. I'm like, oh, let's just see how this works. And, you know, if it doesn't, that's okay too.
Right. I think you just have to not be afraid to fail at some things and find out what works for you.
Exactly.
Well, I think I have one last question for you. Now, I know you told me many times that you're not pop culture inspired that much, but I was looking at the hair tie names, Pretty in Pink, Summer Night, Neon 90s, G.I. Jane, just some of your hair tie names. And I think subconsciously you do have a link to it, and that kind of rocks. So I just wanted to get that out there. Not a question per se.
Thank you.
But just a statement.
Thank you. I appreciate that. I mean, I will say that my team does name a lot of the stuff too. I just don't. All right. So, you know, I grew up in Maine, and I grew up on a dirt road with one other house, barely watched TV. You know, I always say, I'm like, I could probably recognize like two celebrities if I saw them on the street. When I moved to LA, one of my friends, she goes, you really need to start, you know, paying attention to really what's going on. So I acknowledge that I could, because we are such a pop culture driven society. And I appreciate what, I like what you guys had said. I think it was on your first podcast that I listened to, that it bonds people. It get, you know, yeah. it almost like levels the playing field. There's no like ego there or anything. It's just kind of like, oh, you like this, I like this. You could get some, you know, people from completely different worlds, but they like the same TV show, right? And I, or, you know, the same right. artist. And I think that is a really beautiful thing.
Absolutely. So one last thing here, Joanna, if I can refer any of my friends over to you, obviously you have Instagram. Where else can we find your product?
So KeeneyBands.com is definitely the best way to go. I can make a, you know, let's make a coupon code. We're going to do it.
Nice. Oh, okay. Nice.
So I'm going to make it, can I do Pop Cult X?
Yeah, that would be awesome.
Okay. And we'll do that for, and that'll be a 20% off. So if people want to shop there, check it out. I'll make that right now and that'll be active.
Oh, thank you so much. That's awesome.
Of course. Yeah, thank you guys.
That's very nice. Yeah. Cool. Appreciate
yeah,
that.
Definitely with summer coming up, I think that definitely have to get those swimmer accessories and get ready to go to the beach. I think what Memorial Day weekend's coming up. So a lot of people are going to be out having fun.
Yeah. We're ready for it, huh?
Cannot wait.
Well, thank you again, Joanna, for taking some time this morning to talk to us. And we really appreciate it. Everyone, if you're listening still to this interview, go visit KeeneyBands.com, order all of your hair supply, use coupon code POPCULTX for 20% off. So thank you again, Joanna.
Thank you guys so much. This is fun.
Thank you so much. Have a great day. Be safe.
All right. Thanks, guys.